Parashat Devarim, we start the new book of Devarim, and we start it when Motzei Shabbat, right after the Sabbath, we sit on the floor and mourn for the destruction of the loss of both of our temples and the tragedies of the loss of our national identity in Israel and the enforcement of our exile through the entire world. It's fascinating that the prophet Zechariah says that Tisha B'Av, the day of our mourning, is going to eventually become a day of great rejoicing and a festival. That's how the rabbis explain the possibility of our putting on tefillin, our adornment of our phylacteries, speaking to the men in the main. Our tefillin for us is our jewelry, our precious, precious, precious signs of rejoicing and happiness. How can we put on tefillin, an adornment? How can we be happy during any part of the day of Tisha B'Av? So much tragedy, so much death, so much sorrow. And how can God turn fast days into feast days? Because that seems to be an objective issue. The days that are fast days are days on which we have suffered. The days that are feast days are days in which we have military victories. We have conquered those who wanted to destroy us. So how can a fast day turn into a feast day? The 9th of Av was a terrible day. And we lost so many people from the Romans, at the hands of the Romans. What's the basis for the joy? There's an amazing midrash on the verse in Zechariah that says these days will become feast days at the time of the redemption. And the midrash puts it very well. Yes, undoubtedly we suffered terribly on Tisha B'Av, and then all the fast days. However, despite the terrible suffering, fundamentally God took out his wrath against us on the sticks and stones and wood and fabric of buildings of the Holy Temple. God took out his wrath on objects and enabled the Jewish people to keep living. The other nations that were destroyed, conquered by the Romans, don't exist anymore. We still remain strong. And that was the substance of God's promise to us. Not that we will have a rose garden, not that it will be easy for us. We have a mission, and that mission is to teach the world God's laws of love, to teach the world God's vision for peace. we must teach. And in order to be able to keep on teaching, God promised us that He will never destroy us. We were conquered by the Romans, but they didn't conquer all of us. And many of us, and perhaps even most of us, survived. And that's exactly what the Midrash says. The fact that God didn't destroy us, but kept us alive and enabled us to keep on acting and praying, turning again to God in repentance, and then rebuilding the land of Israel. And now rejoicing from its redemption. What happened on Tisha B'Av was that the Jews were not destroyed when all the other nations were. And on that basis, Tisha B'Av will become a day of rejoicing and happiness. Shabbat Shalom.